What's up? Hey, I want to show you around Terminal 3. This is the new terminal at Manila. Most of the airlines are using it now. So this would be the airline you probably would fly in and out of when you come to the Philippines. It's a pretty nice terminal. It's on par with anything you'll see in the States. Is it going to be on par with the new super terminal in Kansas City, my hometown? Probably not, but they're throwing crap loads of money into that terminal. And the Philippines don't have the money that Kansas City's got either. That's just the reality of it. So, I'm going to walk you around. I'm on the top floor now. There's four floors here. There's a food place over there I'll show you at the end. So now we're down here on the first floor. This is arrivals. I'll show you. There's Burger King. Okay, you got Burger King. You got your car rentals, your hotel over on this side. You got your foreign exchange here. And then we'll just go down there, get your banks. We'll see what else is down there. Got convenience stores running all along here. So this is basically what you do. I know at the other end there's a Wendy's now. Used to be a coffee shop, they went out. Now there's a Wendy's. And that's basically what I'm for. Like I said, just banks and money changers, car rentals, that sort of thing. They do have, I guess, now they quit selling them. They can actually give them away now. Smart Globe, which is like AT&T in the States and Verizon. They give away the SIM cards now. They quit selling them. So the view, that the second floor is all the offices for the airport and the viewing deck. But they said the viewing deck is closed. I was gonna see if I could show you the viewing deck. I think there's another one at the fourth floor. And so I'll show you from there. Okay, now this is the third floor. They got charging stations over there. Charge up your laptop, charge up your cell phones. Charge up anything you need. Some of these guys are going to have 12-hour flights. Most of them will connect in Tokyo or Hong Kong, but I mean, I guess technically you could have a U.S. flight out of here. So this is where all your check-in stuff goes on. If you need to book a ticket, there's Cebu Pacific on that corner, and I believe that Philippine Airlines is on the other side, far side. And I don't think that AirAsia's office is at Terminal 4. And I don't believe that, is that the only airlines? Yeah, that's the only Philippine Airlines. Now, there's only three of them. There's some small airlines, but they're all based over at Terminal 4. But those are the three main ones. So I guess that's it. I guess we only do have three. Okay, so now we are on fourth floor. We got Shakey's, we got Pancake House, Jelly Bee. There's like three Jelly Bees in the building. I don't know why they think people actually eat that stuff, but anyways. We got Yellow Cab, we got McDonald's right there. There's a lot of food stuff up on this floor. This is the primarily, you know, your commerce part of the floor. Because pretty much the third floor is nothing but check-in. So, there's a lot of stuff. There's a Seattle Coffee, 7-Eleven. There's, just a lot of stuff up here. There is Cebu Pacific's check-in. Philippine Airlines, Cebu Pacific's over there as well. And I don't see AirAsia where they're at, but they're probably on the far end. But Yeah, like I said, it's not very busy for being 5 days before Christmas. I'm really surprised. Okay, along that back wall is all your taxes and your fees and everything you're gonna have to pay there. It's gonna be a madhouse down there. Anytime you leave the Philippines, you're gonna have to pay a bunch of fees. It's gonna cost you about 30, 40 bucks to get out of the airport. Just all the different taxes that the Philippines has. So be aware of that. That over there is the Philippine Airlines down there. There's their office in that corner. And there's some more shops down there. You got Subways down there. You got Starbucks is down there. And I'm not sure what else is down there. Now up on the fourth floor, I'll go over there in a minute, you got your KFC, you got Mary Grace, and some restaurants back in there. So we'll go see if we can see the observation deck over here. And a lot of shops here sell U.S. products, or at least U.S. quality made in China, but U.S. branded products. See what we got. Get some M&M's over there. Sounds good. Maybe we'll get some M&M's. So we can see a little bit down here. That's the shops. That's the shops on the back side of the security check-in where you do immigration, customs, and all that. So at least you saw that. One final thing I'll show you. I'll show you the food court over here. Okay, this is the food hall. This is where they have all the food and all that stuff. So we'll check it out to show you what's here. There's into some local restaurants that got started. Over here, like I said, it's Mary Grace, KFC. On the back side is like Army Navy, which is kind of like a, it's a Mexican knockoff, Taco John's, Taco Breno, whatever brand you want to talk about. It's basically a Philippine answer to that. It's decent, but it's kind of pricey for fast food. But other than that, just kind of checking out, seeing where things are. And I will tell you though, and let me check here. I know the prices on for a couple things at Army Navy, so I'll be able to tell you if it's the same price. No. It's about 10% higher. Okay. Now, I did check earlier over here at Max's, which is a chicken place in the Philippines. They are the same price as they are in any other store. As it is, the airport is the same price. And so is Pizza Hut over there. Because I ate at Pizza Hut the other day. And it's the same price. Anyways, I hope this was helpful. Let me know if there's any information I didn't cover about the Terminal 3. There is a shuttle that goes to ETSA. I have a video on that. I'll put that down there. There's also, I didn't cover the cabs. The cabs are outside. They will rip you off. No questions asked. You will get ripped off if you get in a cab, any cab, in the airport. Okay. I think I pretty much covered it. Oh, the only thing I will tell you, if you absolutely, you're live at nighttime and you're not concerned about safety, you can walk across the street to Newport and catch a jeepney to ETSA for 8 pesos. That amount of it. See ya.